Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I will have a little chat with you about beginner guides for adult coloring and my thoughts about it, because when you first start your coloring journey, it is so nice to look up some beginner guides and help you out where to start with coloring and how to layer. And yeah, let's have a look together at some of my first coloring pages, and you can see where I came from. And yeah, I will show you a little bit of my growth, because this was my first coloring book by Joanna Bessford, Mijn Geheime Tuin. It is called Secret Garden in English. And when I started coloring, I only owned one set of pencils and I had a lot of fun with it. And you can see basically every page that I colored was some flat coloring. And I picked out this one to show you. When I'm looking at this page, I can see that I was coloring for a little while already. And that I was watching some ColorTube videos, beginner guides to balance out your colors, that you spread your colors evenly on the page. And you can see all the greens are nicely mapped out. There are some purples and they are going very well together with orange fishies, and there's some pink and some blues. And yeah, looking at it, the colors that I've used are very nice, and I think it's all because of one of the beginner guides that I was looking at the beginning of my journey. But if you look closely, there is no depth. There is no shading. And the thing is, when you get stuck in beginner guides, you will learn how to map out your colors, plan your colors, you will learn what color combinations work together very well, and will get you some pretty results. But really, the coloring techniques you won't learn in a beginner guide. And it is something that I noticed over the times, that a lot of people looking on their social media, having a look at their own coloring and think, oh, it is very pretty. And then they came across someone on YouTube or on Instagram or on Facebook or on Pinterest, and finding a page looking like this and comparing themselves against a picture like this. I've colored this one with a tutorial by Chris Cheng, and I think Chris Cheng is a perfect example for someone that is a master in coloring. I cannot say it different. She is amazing. And I could color a lot like this. Simply base layers. And I jumped, when I was coloring like this, I jumped in one of her tutorials. Even I was thinking, looking at my own coloring, I'm still a beginner colorist. But thinking you are a beginner colorist, you will always stay a beginner colorist. So, you have to move on. Don't get stuck in those beginner tutorials. Really, those are very great when you first start out and don't know where to start and what you like. And those are perfect. But by following someone else's tutorial with some mind-blowing coloring techniques, you will learn so much more to grow in your own coloring on your own pages. Like this one. I followed the tutorial for this side, and the same techniques I've used on this side, and I'm happy with the outcome of it. I clearly can see a lot of things that I can change. This is not that pretty. I wish I did it different. But allow yourself to grow and dive in some more challenging pages. Challenging techniques will that you grow in your coloring. So I did also one for my own, without following any tutorial. I just take my time and I use the techniques that I learned on those pages. I put it on this page. The shading, the layering, the blending. And if I will always following beginner guides, I will learn and teach myself the same thing all over again. And just because I was brave enough to dive in a difficult type of coloring page, I was able to color things like this. And yeah, it made me feel very proud that I was able to color this beautiful beach scene. And yeah, it is one of my favorite pictures that I've colored. I'm very proud at it, and yeah, I think it is necessary to jump in harder pictures and harder blending techniques, and yeah, give yourself the permission to grow and experiment, and maybe also to fail. If you don't know where to start, you can always start with a coloring book that has an example page next to it. This is a coloring book full of pretty doll pictures. I think those are mostly girls and a lot of flowers. Sorry. I'm so sorry. I had to sneeze. And you can really challenge yourself to copy this side of the picture. Take it as a reference picture and try to match the color so closely as possible. I know it won't be exact the same thing, but this way you can, yeah, allow yourself to grow and challenge yourself. This is the picture that I've colored, and you can see it is not even close to the original. But it was a lot of fun. I really liked the roses, how I've colored them. I like the face, and I can, yeah, clearly see that I still can use a lot more depth and definition in the face. It can use a lot more layers, and that is something that I've learned while coloring this picture. And recognize the things you are able to grow. Yeah, you can learn from it, and I like it. And you can see that I color the leaves very dark compared to the background, and the original cut the lighter leaves and a more dark background. I'm liking it. It was a fun page, and I try to match the colors and I learn from it. There are a lot of books with example pages next to it. So if you like to dive in and want to grow and get better at your coloring, this is a great option. And of course you can change some colors if you like it better to add a blue background and there was an orangey one in the original, and that's okay. One thing that I've learned in my beginner guides and that I really use until today in a lot of my pictures is using a limited color palette. You can see I have used the same color palette on both of the pages, and both of the pages turned out totally different. You clearly can see this is one of my earlier pictures and the way I have blended, and yeah, it was a nice, creative, fun, experimental way of coloring, and I liked it. But I went with my own color palette, my own way, and the only thing that I've used from the video, the beginner guide, was use a cohesive color palette. So sometimes it is great to watch them and, yeah, change it for your own pages how you can use it, or but don't follow everything from the first word in the beginner guide to the end, and just pick out the little things you can use. Then another thing, because when I first started coloring, this is more a beginner friendly picture. You can see I just throw in some of the black pencil. I didn't use any shading on those. Yeah, I turned them into killer whales, but those are really dolphins. And there is not that much definition. And when I was looking up a reference picture from some other animals, that's a great thing about the book. In the back of the book, those are all named, so you can look up the reference pictures. And I, yeah, use it as a reference picture, and I allowed myself to grow this way and get better and really took my time with it. So the thing that I, yeah, the point that I wanted to make today is allow yourself to grow. Don't get stuck into those beginner guides, because when I was coloring like this, I was feeling overwhelmed when I saw someone on the internet, on the socials, coloring like this. And I was always thinking, I cannot do it. But allow myself to play and take my time with it. I went from this beginner type coloring to this because I took my time and I allowed myself to grow. And that is the point that I want to make. Dive in. Have fun. Challenge yourself. And yeah, grow. Have a lot of fun coloring. And yeah, see where you end up. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.